Bible said in the book of Zechariah that their heart is an adamant stone. Praise the Lord, you can't hardly break it. Listen, people that hardened their hearts against God. Hallelujah, that the Spirit of God can't even penetrate them anymore. The Spirit of God, hallelujah, can't bother them no more. Did you know what? People have sat and sat and sat and sat and sat and rejected God until their hearts have gotten so hard. Hallelujah. The Lord upbraided them because of the hardness of their heart and the unbelief. Praise the Lord. Thomas wasn't the only one. Hallelujah. Because they believed not them which had seen him after he had risen. Praise the Lord. Let's turn to Luke 13 and 23. Luke 13 and 23. Then said one unto him, Lord, are there few that be saved? And he said unto them, strive to enter in at the straight gate. For many. Glory. For many. Gonna be a lot of people. Hallelujah. For many is gonna say, Lord, Lord. Have we prophesied in your name, God? Have we done many mighty wonderful works in your name, God? Hallelujah. Oh, God, for many shall seek to enter in and shall not be able. Hallelujah. You know why they're not going to be able? Because they've hardened their hearts. Hallelujah. They're half-hearted. Did you know something? We can't serve God just when we want to serve Him. We can't live for God just when we want to live for Him. Hallelujah. We just can't do what we want to do. Praise the Lord. We've got to give God our whole heart. You know something? This is not, this life is not just about what I want to do. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. I've got to do what God tells me to do. Praise the Lord. I got to go when He says go. You know something? The other night I was at Walmart. Praise the Lord. And I seen this individual. And I started to turn and go around and go away from him. Praise the Lord. But and God just put it on my mind. And I said, no, I've got to go to this individual. I went down there and talked to him. Praise the Lord. I'm not going to get into all of it. But did you know something? What if I'd not obeyed God? What if I'd have went on and been about my merry way and kept my shopping and doing what I wanted to do? Praise the Lord. But God wanted me to do that. Hey, we can't do our own thing. We can't go when we want to. We can't do when we want to. We got to do as God tells us to do. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hey, Thomas wasn't the only one that doubted. Praise the Lord. There are a lot of people that have turned from this truth. A lot of people have turned away from God. They've hardened their hearts until God can't penetrate it no more. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Let's hold on to that. Let's go to 2 Chronicles 25 and 1. 2 Chronicles 25 and 1. Amasa was 25 years old when he began to reign. And he reigned 29 years in Jerusalem. And his mother's name was Jedidah of Jerusalem. And he did that which was right in the sight of the Lord, but not with a perfect heart. Listen to what he said. He did that was right in the Lord, but not with a perfect heart. Did you know something that we can do for God? We can do the things that we feel like that we need to do for God. But if we don't do it willingly, you know what? Many people, they don't live for God. They try to live for God, but they really don't want to live for God. Praise the Lord. They try to live for the Lord, but they really don't want to. Hallelujah. You know what that is? That's half-hearted. That's half-hearted. Hey, you can't serve God and mammon too. God's got to have our whole heart. Everything matters. Praise the Lord. He's got to have our whole body, soul, and spirit, and our mind. We got to back to Luke. When once the master of the house is risen up and had shut the door, and you begin to stand without and to knock at the door saying, "Lord, Lord, open unto us." You know something? I used to preach that this was people that were out in the world. They're going to come and they're going to knock on the door and say, "Now, Lord, have we prophesied in your name? Have we cast out devils in your name? Have we done many mighty wonderful works in your name?" But you know something? I'm not so much going to preach that it's the world anymore. Did you know something? I believe that there's a lot of people, praise the Lord, of God's people, hallelujah, that have turned their heart, has hardened against God. And once the master of the house is risen up, do you know what they're going to do? There's a lot of people that claim to be the church of Jesus Christ that's going to be doing the same thing. They're going to be knocking on the door, and they're going to say, "Lord, have we done this? Have we preached, God, in your streets, Lord? Hey, God, have we done this and done that? We've cast out devils." And you know what God's going to say? "Depart from me. I know you not, which you are."